Are you seeking help on your journey of faith? You're invited to come try First Christian Church in Kirksville. It's time for a fresh start at First Christian Church. Their doors are always open to everyone, regardless of who you are. So, no matter what you're going through, Pastor Tim and congregation are always available to you. Come find answers to your questions at First Christian Church, 100 North High Street in Kirksville. They gather for worship every Sunday morning at 9:30.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome to our online worship at First Christian Church in Kirksville, Missouri. As you can tell, we are not in the sanctuary this morning, but due to cold and windy and just nasty weather outside, we decided to cancel in-person worship service and have online worship service this morning. So we are so glad that you can join us. Just some short announcements about what's going on in the life of First Christian Church, Kirksville. On January 16th, 2024, The general board will meet at 5:30 p.m. in the parlor. And then also starting January 29th through March 4th, I am going to lead a Lenten Bible study. And we'll have two sessions on Mondays from 11 to noon if you want to bring your lunch. And then on Monday evenings from 6:30 to 7:30 p.m. There is a sign-up sheet in the Narthex. The cost of the book is $4.20. If you need to order a book, contact Joy in the office because we have some copies that we purchased for you to purchase. So if you have any questions about the Bible study, we're looking forward to it. Feel free to give us a call and also fill in the sign-in sheet that is in the Narthex. Again, welcome to First Christian Church, Kirksville, Missouri. We are so glad that you are here. Please join me in our call to worship. Please feel free to respond after I respond. Here we are, Lord. You have seen us and known us from before the beginning. Here we are, Lord. Jesus, you have called us to this place. Here we are, Lord. Gracious Holy Spirit, inspire our hearts with courage and joy. Amen. Today's readings from 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verses 29 through 31. I mean, brothers and sisters, the appointed time has grown short. From now on, let even those who have wives be as though they have had none, and those who mourn as though they were not mourning, and those who rejoice as though they were not rejoicing. For those who buy as though they had no possessions, and those who deal with the world as though they had no dealings with it, for the present form of this world is passing away. And a reading from Psalm 139, verses 1 through 6 and 13 through 18. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. You search out my path for my lying down and are acquainted with all of my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely. You hem me in behind and before and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain it. For it was you who formed my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works that I know very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes behold my uniformed or unformed substance. In your book were written all the days that were formed for me, when none of them as yet existed. How weighty to me your thoughts are, O God. How vast is the sum of them. I try to count them. They are more than the sand. I come to end. I am still with you. These are the words of God for his people today. Thanks be to God for them. Brothers and sisters, let us pray today. Almighty God, by grace alone you call us and accept us in your service. Strengthen us by your Spirit and make each and every one of us worthy of your call. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen. Well, it's so good to be with you, even if it's from home today. My friends, whether it's prophets in the Bible or the disciples themselves, we see each of them called into the service of ministry. And regardless of their feeling equipped or not, they have answered the call. This morning in 1 Corinthians text, we see the apostles addressing the members of the church in Corinth. We see Paul calling the people to answer God's call for more and more ethical living. Here is the situation that the people faced in the time of the Apostle Paul. They believed that the time of Christ's return was at hand. It was imminent, and that it would come in their lifetime. You see, the people had sort of given up and just decided to wait on the return of Jesus. Even to this day, we feel Christ's return growing closer and closer. But what do we do until that time, whether in our lifetimes or not? You see, just as Paul is telling the church at Corinth, we must, each and every one of us, listen to God's call this morning and understand that now is not the time to cease and desist from the calls that God is sending each and every one of us on. You see, Ephesians chapter 4, verses 25 through 32 tells us the following. Therefore, each and every one of you must put off falsehood and speak truthfully to your neighbor, for we are all members of one body. In your anger, do not sin. Do not let the sun go down while you are still angry, and do not give the devil a foothold. Anyone who has been stealing must steal no longer, but must work, doing something useful with their own hands that they may have something to share with those in need. Do not let any unwholesomeness come out of your mouths, but only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Get rid of all bitterness, rage, and anger, brawling, and slander, along with every form of malice. Be kind and be compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you. The word of the Lord. My friends, what this is telling us this morning is that our first and most important call as Christians is in living our lives ethically, living our lives as Jesus Christ would want us to live. Each and every one of us that has accepted God's call to a personal relationship with Jesus Christ has first and foremost been called to loving others as Christ loves us, as Christ loves the church. You see, this ethical living must be understood in the context that the Apostle Paul did not approve of marriage or other social institutions, but he wants us to live ethical lives that are in motion, lives that are in present anticipation of God's future. which even now has dawned through the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Yes, this Christian life we have chosen, this Christian call that we have answered, tells us that the old life must be given way for a new life and new ways of living. For us that call ourselves followers of Christ, we must live in anticipation of Christ's return. But we also must live our lives as if his return has already begun. If we live our lives as if his return is already underway, we must live our baptismal calls and begin by showing the returning Christ to the world, to all who we encounter. We do this by living a Christly life, a Christ-filled life, by letting society witness and learn about Christ through our actions as well as our dealings with people and the world around us. Beloved, there is a cycle of God's call for our lives. Melissa Lauber, in her 2011 article in Ministry Matters, gives us the five cycles of following God's call for our lives. And if you're sitting at home, hope you are, and watching this, have a piece of paper and write this down. The cycle of God's call. While some people sense their calling like a lightning bolt sent straight forth from God, most go through a series of steps or cycles of discernment and action. The steps of the cycle are, first of all, number one, revelation. When you get a clear glimpse of God and what God is calling you to be or God is calling you to do. Secondly, resistance, a phase filled with doubt and questions. Thirdly, commission. God's voice becomes clearer and you feel compelled to respond. Fourthly, partnership, a time when your call begins to fit into the church or other ministries and your call becomes part of the community's call. And then finally, fifthly, service. You move into action, bringing God's call into life. Revelation, resistance, commission, partnership, and service. Let us take these five cycles of God's call for our lives and let us focus on how and what this means for us and living ethical lives of love and service to others. Each one of these cycles is much more than a job or a mission calling. It is a way of living, a way that a Christian must live. When we get a glimpse of what God is calling us to be or to do, we get a glimpse of how our lives must be changed because Christ has forever changed them. Evil will occasionally cause us resistance to ethical living. These are choices that each and every one of us faces daily and must understand that we have answered God's call. And evil must decrease as our new lives in Christ must increase. By being God's word and retaining prayer life relationship with God, you see, we can keep the connection of his call for our lives open and to openly understand and as to have our lives sustained. My friends, when we live lives that are ethical, we understand the partnership that we have formed as people of God's church and the partnership that we have in our communities and our world around us. Firstly and foremost, ethical lives in Christ are in service to others. Let me say it again. Ethical lives in Christ are in service to others. First and foremost is how we treat and how we respect the humanity around us. Beloved, our expectations and God's call for our lives begin at home with our husbands, our wives, our children, our family. Yes, each and every one of us has a responsibility, a Christian responsibility, whether Christ returns within 100 years or 100 seconds. The lives that we live, the lives that we lead must be Mark chapter 1, 15 lives. The time has come, he said. The kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news, the word of God. Yes, the Lord is coming, but we, like the church at Corinth, must not stop.
We must not slow down. We must not grow weary. We must continue to love our spouses. We must continue to love and raise and nurture our children. We must suppress grief and live joy. We must not ignore the people and the world around us. We have a call, and his name is Jesus Christ. He is coming, and he is on his way. Do not let the world dictate your life, but rather let the world see that Jesus Christ, the King of Kings, dictates your lives, my life, our lives, and the way that we live is showing others that he is on his way. Do not be controlled by the world, but rather embrace God and the loving direction that he has given our lives. Eugene Peterson wrote the following in his book called The Message. Dear Corinthians, I can't tell you how much I long for you to enter this wide open, spacious life. We didn't fence you. The smallness you feel comes from within you. Your lives aren't small, but you are living in a small way. Open your lives. Live openly and expansively. Friends, I leave you today with this message. Live your lives openly. Never be afraid or never be embarrassed of God's call for your life. Never let the world fence you in from living and leading ethical lives of faith. Open your lives to the world as God's people and let them see your happiness so they can experience their own godly call for their lives. Amen and amen. This is God's word for today. As we come to our time of communion, as we partake of the Lord's table, whether in the sanctuary or whether watching from home, each and every one of us partakes this morning of the body of Christ and the cup of Christ. And it affects us and touches us and directs us in different ways. My message this morning about calling ourselves disciples means living lives that God wants us to live, living lives that are ethical, and it also means living lives in which we represent the sacrifices, the gifts, the glories of Christ, where we represent the table every day of our lives of people who have given our lives to Jesus Christ. We represent the body of Christ given for us and the blood of Christ shed for us. So as we come to the communion table this morning, know that all are invited to partake. All are welcome at the table of the Lord. On the night that our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ gathered with his disciples in the upper room, he took the bread and he blessed it and he broke it
And he said that this is my body given for you. Eat this as often as you do in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he poured the cup and blessed it and said that this is the cup of the new covenant. Drink this as often as you do in remembrance of me until I return for my kingdom, the cup of Christ. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this table. May we partake of these elements today. And may we take what we have eaten, what we have drank, what we have learned, what we have gleaned, and take it into our communities as your disciples, the disciples of Christ. May the bread and the cup lead us to those who are in need of what the table represents, forgiveness and love. Lord, we thank you for the elements of communion today. May we live them, teach them, and share them. In the name of Christ Jesus, amen. This is the body of Christ. And this is the cup of Christ.
Love divine, all loves excelling, joy of heaven to earth come down. Fix in us thy humble dwelling, all thy faithful mercies ground. Jesus, thou art all compassion, pure unbounded love thou art. Visit us with thy salvation, and to every trembling heart. Finish then thy new creation, pure and spotless let us be. Let us see thy great salvation, perfectly restored in thee. Changed from glory into glory, till in heaven we take our place. Till we cast our crowns before thee, lost in wonder, love, and praise.
This concludes our service at First Christian Church in Kirksville, Missouri. We want to thank you for joining us online today. We ask that you continue to be safe. We ask that you continue to take care of yourselves, check on your neighbors, check on the homebound. Please take care of your pet kids and just continue to love one another and be disciples to all those that you encounter, to all those that you meet, in the name and in the love of Jesus Christ. Now go forward in the love of Christ, in the peace of Christ, in the glory of Christ, in the presence of Christ, knowing that you are loved, and God, the one true God, will never let you go. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Go in peace.